ofness of Christ. Amen. So we got to do this here. You got to do this here until Christ come. Right. See, when Christ come, you'll be still working. Amen. Amen. So now he's going to be working in you spiritual-wise while you walk in the earth. Amen. I want to encourage you to pray, study, fast, meditate, and seek him. Because he got a powerful work for you. That's one of your purpose, is to walk this earth and proclaim the gospel. Amen. Praise the Lord. You know, and it said, and do it, in other words, got to make sure that people, all us coming to the knowledge of the Son of God. Amen. Number two, it's two ways they can come into the knowledge of God. You can teach them to come into the knowledge of God. And number two, you can live it. They can see you living it. And then they'll get the knowledge of God. You won't only just be talking, you'll be living it. Amen. Praise the Lord. And then it says, unto the measure of the fullness, the measure and the stature and the fullness of Christ. See, the only way that people, they're going to come into the fullness of Christ is by working through you. That's your purpose. To stand before the people and proclaim the word of God. As an evangelist, he worked through an evangelist in a powerful way. So always be prayerful, daughter, and seek him. Amen. So that's a state of purpose. I can go on and on, but today is her day. And it's time for us to hear from her. Amen. We just pray that God come and just use her in a mighty way. Amen. So at this time, I'm going to present to some that know her and to some that don't. Amen. Evangelist Kamika Foster Walker. Receive her by the elevating of your hand. Kamika Walker, preach the word. God bless you, baby.
Find favor in your sight. got to be where you are. I wanna be where you are. I gotta be where you are. Come on, help me say, I wanna be where you are. I gotta be where you are. I wanna be.
Today. I am so honored. To Elder Foster, First Lady Foster, all ministers, friends, and family, to my husband Chris and my boys, Cameron and Chase, and I love you and thank you for your support. Okay, so my daddy didn't tell me, well, he did tell me that when you accept your call and expect the test to come, but I be Lord God. I did not know my test was going to be like it was this week. So I'm going to share a little bit about my test this week. Monday, I was nauseated. My back was hurting. Chris went and got me some Tylenol, extra strength. Tuesday, my phone was stolen. My smartphone was stolen. I can laugh because at first I was upset, and I talked to one of my friends from work, and she was saying that sometimes God can remove stuff that's a distraction to you. So I'm not going to say her name because I don't want her to, you know, go off. But anyway, so God revealed that to me, that, oh, my God, he took my phone from me because it was a distraction. I don't know about you, but I read my Bible on my phone. So if I'm looking in my Bible on my phone, this is my phone, and I'm reading and a Facebook notification come up or an email alert, I got distracted. So she brought to my mind that people need to go read their Bible the old-fashioned way. Yeah. You know, sometimes we get caught up with using our cell phone.
Yeah.
You need to use your word.
Amen.
Okay, so I'm going to do what I was called to do. So get ready. Okay, so let me pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for this moment right now, Lord. I ask you to come in right now. I ask you to dwell, have your way in this place. Lord, I ask that you allow Kamika to decrease and that you increase and you speak and have me say only what you would have me to say. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, so please turn in your Bibles to John chapter 3. And while you're looking, you know, find it. My topic is in the form of a question, and that question is, who are you?
Jesus.
Who are you? Who are you? Do you know who you belong to?
Jesus.
Who do men say that you are?
Jesus.
Who are you?
All right.
Are you a child of the King?
Yes.
or are you a child of Satan? So I'm reminded of the story in the Bible about a man named Nicodemus. In John chapter 3, it tells us a story about Nicodemus actually thinking that when Jesus told him that he had to be born again, that he had to enter in his mother's womb for the second time. I don't know about y'all, but I'm glad that is not possible. Thank you, Jesus. So, John chapter 3 says, there was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher from God, for no man can do these miracles that thou doest except God be with him. Jesus answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus said unto him, How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? Jesus answered, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. Except a man be born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. Except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. Amen. That which is born of flesh is flesh, and that which is born of spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I said unto thee, ye must be born again. Ye must be born again. Ye must be born again. The wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but canst not tell whence it cometh and whither it goeth. So is everyone that is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus answered and said unto him, How can these things be? Jesus answered and said unto him, Art thou a master of Israel and knowest not these things? Verily, verily, I say unto thee, we speak that we do know and testify that we have seen, and ye receive not our witness. If I have told you earthly things, and ye believe not, how shall ye believe if I tell you heavenly things? And no man hath ascended up to heaven, but he that come down from heaven, even the Son of Man which is in heaven. We should make sure we're ready. That should be our first priority, to make sure we're ready to see God. Death is one appointment that you cannot cancel or reschedule.
That's right.
We all have an expiration date. Please do not wait. At my job, I work at Maxwell Air Force Base, and I book appointments for patients that's of the military family members. And sometimes they'll call and they say, ma'am, I need to cancel my appointment. I need to reschedule. Something came up for other reason. I can't make it. Death is different. For example, if God said, Coco, your time is up. You can't say, wait, Lord, no. Let me cancel and reschedule death's appointment and get right. Lord, give me some more time. So I can make it to heaven. That's not how it works. When your time is up, whether you are ready or not, it is up. I'm not saying that I'm perfect because I'm not. I am grateful for how my parents raised me in the church. We were in church on Tuesday for choir rehearsal, Wednesday for Bible study, Friday for prayer meeting, Sunday for church, and sometimes even service. Lord, have mercy. Basically, the church was my second home. But growing up, I've always heard people say, I'm having fun. I'm going to wait until I get older to get saved. That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
Yeah.
Young people do die. Death is real, and it does not have an age. For example, I was on Facebook the other day on one of my cousins' page. I can't remember which one. But she shared a story about a girl that was in Chicago that got killed because a man approached her, and she declined. She was not interested in him. He shot her 3 times, and she died. And he shot in the crowd, and 5 other people were injured. I'm pretty sure that this mother did not think that when she left, this was going to be her last day on earth, and she left 3 children here. She left 3 children here.
Great church.
So the reason why I share this story with you is because you never know what's going to happen the next second, the next 5 minutes, the next hour. You're not guaranteed the next second. So ask yourself this question. If God sent his son, Jesus, today, If God sent Jesus today,
come on, sir.
If God sent his son Jesus today, would you be ready? Would you be ready? Would you be ready? Are you sure that you would make it into heaven? Why would you want to choose hell as your eternal home? You will be on fire. Have you ever burned yourself and you remember the pain that you felt? It wasn't a long pain. But I remember when me and Tisha was younger and we stayed with Grandma, and oh my goodness, I think I was cooking bacon. And I burnt my arm, and to this day I still got that scar. And I made a vow that I would never ever cook pork bacon again. I married a man that loved pork bacon, so I still cook it. But she told me to hush that noise up and go rub some butter on my arm, and that's what I did, and the pain went away.
Jesus.
But
Jesus.
Think about this as an ongoing feeling.
Jesus.
That pain that I felt, it only lasted a couple of seconds after the butter. But just, if you don't have butter, just think about that being an ongoing feeling.
Jesus.
Jesus, God. Jesus, have mercy.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. I can remember that pain being forever. That pain, if you go to hell, is burning forever.
Jesus.
Salvation is one gift that is free, and the cost has already been paid for us.
Jesus.
I said the cost has already been paid. You don't have to pay nothing. It's already been taken care of. John 3:16 says that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life.
Mm-hmm.
Choose Jesus and you will live forever. Everlasting life. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away.
Yes,
behold,
yes.
All things are become new.
Yes.
Not some. All things are become new.
Yes.
When you accept Jesus as your Savior, you are a new creature. Your old man should be dead or should die eventually. I'm not saying that old things or habits that you did when you were living for the devil will end instantly. For some of us, it may, but for others, it may take longer. This is when the saved people, hey, glory, yes, this is when the saved people should continue to pray for those that desire to be saved and not talk negative about them.
Yes.
Oh, wait. I ain't talking about nobody here today. That don't happen here. We should be different. 1 Peter 2:9 says that we are a peculiar people. Be the example. Some of us will be the only Bible that some people may read.
That's right.
So ask yourself today, who are you? Who are you? The Bible tells us in Matthew 6:24 that we cannot serve two masters, for you will hate one or love the other. Please don't wait. God is a gentleman. He allows you to make the decision. Please choose this day who you will serve. Please choose this day who you will serve. Please choose this day who you will serve. Who are you? Are you a child of the king or a child of the devil? It's your choice. Who are you? Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. I'm going to read that again. Romans 6:23. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Yes.
Jesus is the way.
Yes.
Who are you?
Jesus.
Who are you? Who are you? Jesus. One more verse. I think one more verse. But Romans 10:9 says that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth.
Come on.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
All right.
Jesus.
Jesus.
The Lord Jesus.
Yes.
And shalt believe in thy heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. If you confess with your mouth.
Yes.
Confess with your mouth. So in my closing,
It's all right. Come on.
All right.
I encourage you all to be sure that you are saved and that you are living for Christ and not the devil. God has supplied us with the tools that we need. Who are you? Jesus asked his disciples in Matthew 16, who do men say that I am?
All right.
They replied, some say John the Baptist, Elias, Jeremiah, and one of the prophets. When he asked his disciples, who do you say that I am? Peter replied, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus said, flesh and blood did not reveal that to you, but my Father which is in heaven. Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? Be blessed and encouraged and live for Christ and not Satan. And I pray that you all be ready when Jesus comes. Thank you for your time. Thank you, God.
bless your name.
Praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord.
Kamika sent me a Facebook me what I sing for her first sermon, and of course, you know, I said yes. I definitely do it. What you want me to sing? But as she said, when God calls you to do things, you know, a test is thrown at you. So all week my voice has been hoarse, and I'm like, I can't do it. The song that I was gonna do, I hadn't even got the music for it. And a sister of mine, I talked to her this morning, she said, Kara, God telling me, if he called you to do it, he's going to be the one that's going to minister through you. It don't matter what you sound like, it's not about you. So I got up and texted a friend of mine, I said, I need this song, the instrumental version, can you get it for me? This is at 12:30. In 30 minutes, he said, I got the CD for you. I said, God, I know it's meant for me to do it. So I just pray that y'all pray with me as I sing this song. God, use me, less of me, more of you. And in the name of Jesus, I hope that it bless somebody. Call him when you want him. Look at myself in the mirror. Religion looking back at me. I threw my hands in the air, and the Lord rest in me. After the next, just getting by, letting you figure me. Call him when you want him, but Jesus, yeah, Jesus, yeah, Jesus. No other. have a name. Jesus.
Name of Jesus. You know, she did a wonderful job. Wonderful job. She, like she's been in training all her life, did a wonderful job. But God said, who he called, he equipped. He equipped her for this first time. Amen. But she need to be encouraged. She need to be encouraged because as a woman preaching the gospel, you got some men out there, some pastors in some places saying, God didn't call women to preach. But when Jesus rose from the dead, what did the disciple do? He spoke to the woman, go tell. Who carried him 9 months? A woman. Man didn't carry. Man, just, God just spoke into her spirit. But God used who he pleased. He used who he pleased. So it is time to call Sister Thomas to come and give her a word of encouragement.
I want to give glory to God. I just thank God today. Give God a hand clap of praise in here. God is truly been used in this church today. The Spirit of the Lord is in this church today. I feel a healing angel coming in here. With Lakara, you did wonderful, girl. You did awesome. I just want to give God the glory. But for you, Mika, you brought the Spirit up in here. You brought Jesus with you, girl.
Yes.
You is on fire for God. God, just keep blessing you and protecting you. And I speak life over you, Mika. I see you at Women's Conference. God going to do a mighty work in you. He's going to do a new thing in you. I just give God the glory, and I bless God today and give him honor. Thank you. And I love you.
Hallelujah. Any more women's minister that want to stand and encourage her?
Lift your worship
in your sight.
Lord, please, hear my heart's cry. I'm desperately
it up,
sing for your glory.
Glory. gotta be where you are. I wanna be where you are. Gotta be where you are. Come on, raise it before him, say,
wanna be where you are.
Gotta be.
Gotta be where you are.
I wanna be where.
Wanna be where.
Wanna be where,
wanna be you, where are. You are.
Oh, I gotta be there.
Gotta be where you are.
Come on, worshiper, tell him I wanna be where you are.
Wanna be where you are.
Gotta be where.
Everything I need is where.